Learn Excel from Mr. Excel, podcast episode 2328, number the visible rows. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question from Jennifer in Daytona. Jennifer has a data set. She wants to filter to tomato. Tomato is their best-selling product. And then number just the visible records. Fill the other records with dash or hyphen hyphen. All right, so here, filter by selection. I get all of the tomatoes. And I'm like, well, this is going to be easy. Put the one, hold down the control key, grab the fill handle and drag. Doesn't work. I guess because we have a filtered data set, not going to work. So I said, Jennifer, what do you do with the non-tomato records? She says, I put a dash. Are you sure you're never going to enter numbers there? She says, right. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to count all of the numbers above us. So from E dollar sign one, colon, right now we're in row four, so we'll say E3. Count how many numbers are above us and add one, like that, right? And then I copy that all the way down to the end of the data. Control V, I get the numbers 1 through 134. And then when I clear the filter, we should see that only the tomato records are numbered. Now, to put the dashes in, let's see how we're gonna do that. I'm gonna choose all the other records. And we'll use Control G for go to, special, blanks, okay, and now apostrophe, dash, dash. That way it's not a minus sign, it's not seen as a formula. Control Enter, like that. All right, so provided that no one ever types a number in here, that appears like it's gonna work. But then I started to think, well, if this was my data, I might want to really number everything, right? So we kill the filter, we don't need the filter here. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna count, equal count if, how many things above me, and this is gonna be one of those awesome expanding ranges. See dollar sign one to the current row, C2, no dollar sign there on C2 is equal to C2. Double click to copy that down, and we'll just get a mix of numbers, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 3, and so on. But the beautiful thing here, let's say I choose anything, Kiwi, and filter by selection, I get the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, in order like that, right? So that's not what Jennifer was trying to do, but still a cool trick either way. If you like these tips, please, down below, subscribe and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. And check out my new book, Mr. Excel 2020, Seeing Excel Clearly. Click that I in the top right-hand corner for more information. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.